we're at the rehearsal dinner. Hollows and Charleroi. Just finished at the church.
Let's get this ready to eat. Get this weekend started.
Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to St. Damien of Molokai Parish as we come together to share with Ross and Chelsea in this happy occasion in their lives. Let us begin our prayer as we begin all of our prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and comes to..."
They have known each other since they were 5 years old, in kindergarten together, went through school together, graduated together, and they were about to go off to college at different colleges. And Ross figured, well, this might be my last chance. I better ask her out on a date. So he did. I think they went to the Olive Garden for dinner that night. And they had been dating ever since, for the last 8 years. But a couple of years ago, in February, they were walking along the North Shore in Pittsburgh, and Chelsea thought that they were going to the Rivers Casino that evening. But as they got right near Heinz Field there, where the Mr. Rogers statue is, I guess Ross, I think he got down on one knee and asked her to marry him. She said yes, and here we are today. Church minister, your family and friends, and this community. Christ above you, he blesses your love. He has already consecrated you to baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Ross and Chelsea, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children loving you from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you now to turn toward each other, join your right hands, and declare your consent before God and his church.
I rush to take you, Chelsea, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you, in good times and bad, in sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you and honor you
all the days.
All the days.
I, Chelsea, take you, Ross, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you and honor you
all the days
of my life.
Chelsea, take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
The name of the Father.
The name of the Father.
Ross, take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Now that we have heard God's word in the Bible and experienced the Lord's presence in this exchange of vows, let us present these prayerful petitions for people in the world today.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For leaders of church and state, for heads of institutions, for heads of homes and households, that they will lead us and guide us in the search for God and the good life, in the search for peace and joy, in the search for love among us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married people, for those who married yesterday, for the new couple, Ross and Chelsea, married today, for those who will marry tomorrow, that they may savor the joy of being together, warm love and children, a long life, wine and friends, and a new day every day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Thank you. try to domesticate you, but you're an animal. Baby, it's in your nature. Just let me liberate you. You don't need no papers. That man is not your maker. And that's why I'm gonna take a good girl. I know you want it. I know you want it. I know you want it. You're a good girl. Can't let it get past me. Not far from plastic.
The best man has prepared a few words he would like to say. the speech short and sweet, because we all know Serena's speech is going to kill her. My brother's one of the brightest and most loyal people that I know. He would do anything for anybody, and I know how long he's been waiting for this day. When he chose me to be his best man, I started thinking of things I could get on him about. And I can honestly say, I cannot think of many things. I shared a room with a kid for 18 years and could not think of a thing to make fun of him. Except one. We all get no routine in our lives, but he could take it to a new level. As Ross got older, he was so regimented that if something was out of order, the timeline he had set for himself, he'd be completely thrown off. I mean, he could adapt, but not without getting disgusted. The first thing I can remember was when we bought video games. If he didn't get to play first, he'd be very upset and didn't want to play at all. So most times I let him play first because there wasn't much fighting over here. Then once he was able to drive, he started cutting my grandma and grandpa's grass. He'd have a set day and time when he wanted to cut that grass. If it was Saturday at 10 a.m., he had to cut it exactly at that time. I'd say, Ross, they're calling for 10 inches of rain today. Doesn't matter, I gotta cut it at 10 a.m. on Saturday. Sometimes he'd come home at night and Mom would neatly fold his clothes or put mail on his bed. He'd throw a fit. Why did Mom put this stuff on my bed? I'd say, relax, Ross, it can move very easily. He was just upset that his bed was not exactly how he left it. Eventually, he started to date Chelsea after high school, and this immediately changed his routine. He went to Chelsea's house every single night. I'd say to him, Ross, stay home and watch a Super Bowl with me. Nope, gotta go to Chelsea's. Or Ross, there's a foot of snow on the road. Stay home tonight. Doesn't matter, gotta go to Chelsea's. The funny thing about all this is that I'm beginning to be that way a little bit. Lauren can tell you my weekends are now planned out. Exactly. And I guess he began to be a little bit like me after the bachelor party incident, so. I mean, it's obviously not a bad thing, it's just usually that younger people fly by the seat of their pants. I didn't get upset once he began going to Chelsea's because I knew that he loved her and fallen in love. I'm so glad that the person he fell in love with was Chelsea. When you want to spend every single night with a girl, you obviously love her. She's probably one of the only ones that could put up with the old man inside of Ross. She's a wonderful girl and she fits in with our family perfectly. I'm so glad to have a new sister like her. Which brings us to why we're here, to celebrate the marriage of Chelsea and Ross. I don't even have to give either of you any advice, because I know your love is as strong as mine and Lauren's. I'm so happy my brother's found what I found, that's true love and happiness. Chelsea and Ross, I love both of you guys. Congratulations. Now, can we please raise our glasses or whatever we have in front of us? Cheers to the beautiful bride and groom. Salute.
Now, I would like to keep our attention on the head table, but Matron of Honor has a few words she would like to say.
Good evening, everybody. For the few people that don't know me, I'm Serena, the very proud big sister of our glamorous bride here tonight, and I want to start off by congratulating Chelsea and Ross and thanking everybody who came here today to celebrate with us, our Vegas family, our Baltimore family, and even people from Cleveland. When I look at Chelsea and Ross, I know that my little sister has found her true match. And I know that theirs would be a marriage of long standing. Speaking of long standing, today is their 8-year anniversary. 8 years! I know both of you will have a wonderful adventure ahead of you, hopefully with lots of babies, because me and these cousins. And with God's blessing, your marriage will last for decades to come. I never knew Ross before he dated Chelsea. It's been what, Ross, like 20 years since like kindergarten, since you guys were dating. So I can't tell you many horrible stories about him, but I can tell you how perfect he is for my sister. He's so easygoing. Something out here. Easy to talk to, great sense of humor, But most of all, he helps us with all of our computer problems. And there's so many, believe me. Now, Chelsea, by the way, if you have something important to tell Ross, make sure it's not during a Bucko game, a Camo game, a Pitt game, a Steeler game. The sportsman he is. And some days won't change. We're so happy to welcome Ross into our family. It's like he already has been for years. We know he's made for us, and we hope we're made for him. Chelsea, I'm going to tell you how beautiful you look today. And to tell you this has been a truly special day for me, being your matron of honor. I've been waiting so long to give this speech. You give true meaning to the word sister and best friend. And I want to thank you for sharing the last 26 years with me. You're truly a master of organization and planning. Just ask anyone who stepped into her second grade classroom. It's perfect. Nothing about one. You've always enjoyed planning all of our vacations and itineraries, unlike me. Always couponing for good deals, unlike me. And how you amazingly renovated your whole house, with Dad's help, of course. A week ago before Vegas came, and it's perfect. Nothing's out on. How's that for planning and a good time? We all loved you from the day you were born, which I do remember. I was 6 years old. I know how much joy you've brought into our lives, and I know how much joy you're bringing to Ross's. But now that I'm an old married lady now of almost 2 years, I have some marital advice for both of you. Chelsea, make sure you expect the toilet seat's going to be up. Expect Sports Center on 24/7. Clothes will be beside the hamper, not in it. And Ross, you know Chelsea likes her massages once a month. And make sure you take those shoes off before you're in our kitchen. But also be each other's best friend. Life throws a lot at you, and it not only helps to have a husband or wife, but also your best friend. So please raise your glasses while I toast my sister and her new husband. Here's to love, laughter, and happily ever after. Cheers!
Cheers! Look at them. All right, Joe, you got to do a good job editing this. That's it's right. Going to be shaky and it's going to be all over the place, but I still expect my $2.
There's going to be two. You got it.
It'll be a director's cut of all the lost footage.
You're awesome.
Thank you.
Miss Christine Bowker will take the dance floor.
Check them out now. To get lucky.